Students passionately debate various environmental topics, showcasing their knowledge and skills. Moses Buyera, the head teacher of Mbale Secondary School and the host of the regional debate, addresses the audience, proudly revealing that the school has banned the use of polythene bags as part of their commitment to fight and mitigate climate change.
For us here, we already began in our own small way. It's not easy, but for example, we banned the use of Buvuvera. And now we told all the people who sell eats here that we do not want any of these white ones and the black ones. At least that one we have achieved.
John Rex Achela, the resident district's commissioner of Busia, graces the function alongside the debate organizers and school management. Together, they plant a remembrance symbolizing unity in the fight against activities that contribute to climate change.
Estimate about 80 or about 70 of those of you who are here, if I'm not mistaken, members of the jury, in the next future, I have already cited here about 60 members of parliament in this room.
Amidst the intense competition, Mbale Senior Secondary School emerges as the winner among the 10 schools representing the Bugisu Sebei region. They secure their spot to compete in the national competition in September, where the winning team will be awarded the prestigious project prize. Wenyale Mukimba from Mbale SS and Tumusime Triza from Tororo Girls School stand out as exceptional debaters, impressing the judges with their eloquence and knowledge.
Being champions as the time before, but the tournament has been quite interactive. It has been entertaining and at the same time educating. One thing I've learned is that we have to conserve and preserve our environment. But in the quest of preserving and conserving our environment, we have to accept that humanity is entirely dependent on nature, and we ought not to use violence in the conservation of our environment. We ought to seek peaceful means that are going to include every member of society so as we can safeguard our own environment.
We know ways of conserving the environment better, and we have got to know how we are destroying the environment slowly by slowly. If we can get to know how to conserve it better, we are going to have a greener environment and it's going to be just fine. So we have to stop the plastic pollution, we have to stop the burning of rubbish. We have to get ways of cleaning the environment in a way that is not going to be a danger to us.
The Green Schools Initiative project continues to thrive in schools across the country, aiming to combat the adverse effects of climate change. The project manager urges all schools to remain committed to the cause.
If you can concentrate on those activities, the activities you signed on, the commitment you made when we were doing training sometimes in January stroke Feb, you can turn the tables when it comes to the final award of projects. When you see a plastic down, pick it up. Don't wait for the next person. Dispose it in the right place. If each one of us just picks that one habit, there you can create a multiplier effect when people begin to copy what you're doing.
They're emphasizing the need for concerted efforts to reverse the trend of environmental pollution. This story was compiled by Rogers Akanyejuka and Jonathan Metala.